In the lineup, along with Dwayne McClain, Ken Bannister. Also in the ball game is Anthony Sims for Coach Charlie Rosen and David Wood.
And of course, Brent was telling us before the game that he wasn't really feeling very well. He was a little under the weather.
Pass inside to Bannister. Good defense by Blunt. A jump ball. The thing that Blunt did well that time was he just kept his arm up there. He didn't lean his body into the man. That's when he gets caught with a whistle. But Blunt said, hey, if you're going to shoot it, get it over this hand here. And Bannister could not.
Well, the coaches always say, hold your ground, don't commit.
Well, Green's jumping, but it was Blunt who blocked the ball. And it hit the control by the Lightning. Lightning, 27-15 on the year, as opposed to that 28-12 on the Thunder as they try to break a two-game losing streak. Bannister inside, couldn't find the touch. And now, watch your defense, folks. Carmichael against Jones. Young comes up to help out. Carmichael's in the way. Green goes up, and Carmichael knocks it out of bounds. That's what you call basket-to-basket defense by Brent Carmichael.
Well, Brent, he makes a living by waiting for the big guys to bring the ball down and then steal it or knock it away.
Green will lean in, and we've got a whistle and a foul. That'll go against the Rockets for Lightning. You can bet on that. That'll go against Mr. Sims, number 35.
Taking a look at the first quarter scoring, it was Herb Blunt who came through with 9 big points for the Thunder. Sumter had 6. Young had 6. And Green also chipped in with 6 points. Pace Banyan had 12 for the Lightning. McLean.
1 of 2 from the line for Ken Green. Mike Richmond, number 45. You just saw him walk on the floor. He was recently acquired from Rochester for cash. Wood, who's a good 3-point shooter, shows you why. Wood came in with 20 out of 42 from the 3-point range. This is the 3-point shooting team in the CBA, if you haven't already guessed it. Jones works, hangs in the air, and that ball was partially blocked, but he gets it back and hit. Who's got it now? Jones, Blunt, out of bounds. Still belongs to the Quad City Thunder.
That
was blocked out by the official. I couldn't see if Jones still had possession under that or not.
Well, I watched it, and I couldn't believe Drake Jones came down with a couple of rebounds out of that mess.
Nice pass. Anthony Bowie gets his first 2 of the night. Terry Young with some good assists here tonight. And it's 35-31. Quad City Thunder. We're early in the second quarter. And the second quarter's all knotted up in 3. McLean, who's better on the move, misses the jump shot. Ball flapped away. Jones comes out of there with it. Carmichael steals it back. And this is trouble.
Well, that's what he's in there for, Brent Carmichael, to make things happen. He came away with a steal, penetrated, dumped it out to Wood. Wood got the easy 6-footer.
Young out front. Makes a nice pass to Jones, who misses it in close. Jones had to hurry, and that's why he missed the angle. Pass over to Richmond, who walked, and we've got a whistle and a foul. Again, ladies and gentlemen, my opinion that he walked. The official's opinion was that he was fouled, which he was, indeed, after... I say he walked, man, because he didn't have control of the ball, and it looked like it's in for Barry.
No, 3 for Herb Green. Or Ken Green, I'm sorry.
Okay, so Green has 3.
Dumpster
has 2. We've got that straightened away. We can tell you that the Thunder in blue have a 1-point lead. Young working against Mannion. Fade away. That's going to be too hard. Rebound comes down to Pace Mannion, who was almost knocked out of bounds. And a long baseball pass to Sims. We'll find its mark. Brent Carmichael with the assist. And we've got a timeout on the floor as Dan Panazio doesn't like the way the momentum has shifted as the Quad City Thunder now trail for the first time in this one. 36-35. Thunder, who had not trailed in this ball game until that long half-court pass from Brent Carmichael to Anthony Sims moments ago before the timeout by Coach Dan Panazio. 9:21 remaining here in the first half, and Carmichael has mixed it up again, the old fly at the family picnic. He has really created some things here in the last 3 minutes.
Got tremendous quickness, and that always gives the opponent fits, particularly for the Quad City Thunder. Yeah, he's giving Greg Jones a hard time, and things have not gone well for the Thunder here in the second quarter. The quarter scores 8-3, and unfortunately for the Thunder, Rockford is now taking the lead.
Right now, Charlie Rosen resting 3 of his starters. But Terry Young goes against Mannion. Mannion hasn't come out of the game yet. Helps create the turnover. Mannion over to Carmichael on the wing, all the way down. Won't get it. High trying for the rebound as Herb won out to Jones. Fast break, 3-on-2. Jones looks for Bowie. We've got a foul out front, and it's a blocking foul. It's a blocking foul. And Anthony Sims is astonished by the call.
Now he thought he had position, but the D-man went into the paint, which is a little bit farther than you like to see him take it. He and Anthony Bowie on the right wing. He tried to penetrate Bindish off to Bowie, and it just caught too much contact. Call went against Rockford, and the Thunder will have the ball out on the side.
Anthony Bowie, who has one bucket here tonight, and Brent Carmichael got a little too aggressive that time. What made the play was the strength of Barry Sumpter. Barry said, hey, get out of here now.
You know, a lot of times, to be honest, you're going to see that thing, that call not be made because they're going to get a little bit of their arm. The ball's going to come free, and they're going to think they slapped the ball.
Jones, tough shot. Can't get it to fall. Richmond with a rebound, and he threw it out of bounds. Greg Jones got in the passing lane. That pass was intended for Brent Carmichael. Jones zipped up there, and I think he made Richmond change direction. Charlie Rosen there, a man who has a master's degree in medieval art. Is that correct?
Whatever that is.
Medieval art. Bowie open along the wing. Makes a nice pass down to Barry Sumpter. Sumpter wanted to go up and jam it. Had a man in front of him. Hits it off the glass. The Thunder had the lead back, 37-36. They trailed a quarter, 8-5. Mannion has scored 12 in the first quarter in double team. That leaves Carmichael alone for the nice bounce pass to Tim, who made one pass too many, but it'll go up, get it blocked by Blunt. Terry Young expected Blunt to sprint down court, but Herb didn't quite have the burners on, so the ball just went down there where Pace Mannion said, I'll take it. Mannion goes all the way down. They can't let him do that.
Now, you got to stop the man with a dribble. You got to stop him at the top of the key. You can't let him penetrate. And a guy like Pace Mannion, who can handle the ball in the 6'7", can just take it all the way, and he got the layup.
Rockford leads the quarter now 10-5. Young working one-on-one. That's what they want. He'll not get it in and out. Woo! What a rebound that time by Mike Richmond. All the way again is Pace Mannion.
Well, the matchup they have right now presents some interesting problems for the Thunder because you got guys who don't need to be on Dave Woods and also on Pace Mannion, guys that are smaller than them, but you've got guys like Herb Blunt and Sumpter, big guys going out and trying to cover them, and that makes up for some matchup problems, and right now, the Lightning are having the best of them.
And on that last trip down, Anthony Bowie was called for shoving underneath the basket, so Bowie picks up his personal, and the run will have a chance to continue here for the Rockford Lightning, who scored 4 in a row, and he'll try to nail another one down. 7:10 remaining here in the second quarter. Young leans on Mannion. Mannion trying to find that baseline. Shot clock, 2 seconds, 1 second. Carmichael gets it.
Well, the Thunder did everything right there. They played a good defense, got it down to 1 second, but Carmichael came through and hit the key shot.
5-point Rockford lead. Greg Jones against Pace Mannion. He's double-teamed. Mannion knocks it down, but they say Mannion also had some flesh on that hand.
D-man's going to go to the line. You don't especially like to see a guy 6'2 make that kind of a move, as you'll see him take it over to the right side. He's going to end up going 1-on-2 as Wood comes.
Kenny Natt, who hasn't been in the ballgame for quite some time, is now just getting set to check back in. Carmichael works against Greg Jones. David Wood fakes the three. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Sims has trouble with it. And we've got a whistle and a foul.
Anthony Bowie's going to pick up the slapping foul as he reached in, knocked the ball away from Sims. He's going to go to the line.
You can see Anthony trailing the official as if to ask for what particular purpose was the whistle. Let's find out.
You can see it right there as Sims stops. He's being double teamed. Anthony reaches in. Looked like he got all ball, at least from the replay, but the official didn't see it that way.
Kenny Natt checks back in now as Sims, who did a good job off the bench.
In the corner of the shot on the Thunder bench, you can see Ray Hall, and he is not only in his sweats, but he's covering up with a towel over there, which means he's probably got the chills. As you said earlier, Jim, I don't think we're going to see Ray playing tonight's game.
Matt, who is three-point artiste will try. Harry Young has the rebound. Nice bounce pass to Bowie, but there's Carmichael again to knock it away. Anthony Bowie's probably the quickest player on this Thunder team. He does not get guys to come from behind and knock the ball away very often. The two-time Brett Carmichael used that extraordinary quickness that he has to make the play.
And as we have mentioned before during a Rockford Squad City Thunder telecast here on KLJB, Mr. Carmichael and Mr. Bowie, very close friends.
Alley-oop pass inside. Bowie couldn't get it. Green is back, and he is not going to be fouled. They'll say the ball was slapped out of bounds by Kenny Nant. Anthony can't believe he missed that shot.
Well, he's just not getting a break on the roll tonight. He's had three or four shots that have gone in, come back out, bounced off the rim.
Jones outside, not this time, and the Thunder was fighting amongst themselves that time. Jones isn't going to be shot tonight. Rebound fought for. Again, two Thunder had it. And here comes the fast break. Richmond, oh, good defense by Young. But Young will pick up the foul, but he broke up an easy two. Harry Young was back there all alone on a three-on-one. Ran some of these mail.
Actually, as it turns out, you're going to see the fast break over here. Now, the other thing is, once you penetrate so far, you might as well go ahead and take it to the hoop.
Thunder have had offensive problems in this quarter. Richmond missed this, but they get it, or I should say Bannister, they get it right back, and he goes up and scores.
Well, my figures, he missed the foul shot so badly that they got a break and bounced far enough back out that the Lightning could come back up with a ball, and Bannister got an easy 2 points out of it anyway.
The Thunder has scored but 7 points here in the second quarter. Bowie spins and drills it. That was against Pace Mannion, so he earned those two.
Did a little cha-cha step that one time, went up over Pace and got the 2 points.
Quarter lead is in favor of Rockford at 17-9. The game stands 45-41 in favor of the men in white. Inside, and we've got a whistle and a foul. Sumter now has picked up his third personal. Sumter picks up number three with 5:14 remaining here in the second quarter. And Charlie Rosen is by no means a fool. He's got, again, the same result. The Thunder are killing themselves right now. You cannot let free throws go to the offensive team. Miss free throw. Can't do it.
That's going to go, I believe, on Blunt, which is
his one. And Ken Green says no one owns that. Green set a CBA record for rebounding with 623. A couple of years back, Bowie way outside, but he just doesn't. And they're fighting amongst themselves, but Blunt gets it back and goes back out to Young. Got the ball slapped out of bounds. It'll still belong to the Thunder. You can't fault the Thunder for losing rebounds on three different occasions here in the second quarter. Two men have gone for the same rebound. That's aggressiveness, but it's hurting them.
You can't fault them, but at the same point, it's very frustrating if you're the coach and you're sitting on the sideline watching your guys knock the ball away from each other.
Blunt beats Green, who backs in and doesn't get it. The roll is not there for the Quad City Thunder here in the second quarter, but it certainly has been for the Rockford Lightning. They're leaving Carmichael alone for three, and it turned out to be a good idea. We've got a foul from behind on Bannister. He almost knocked Jones.
Well, he went over the back of poor Greg, and Greg went flying, and Bannister is going to pick up the foul. And if you ask Greg, he's probably going to tell you he used great rebounding technique on that one, that he was able to put his body between the basket and Bannister.
11, they lead the ball game, though, only by three. Mannion loves that baseline. Ball was blocked that time by Blunt and still went down.
Hey, you got to cut him off. He's such a good outside shooter that you got to stay with him. And if he can get that step on you, boy, he'll take it right to the hoop every time.
Harry Young with a nice low post pass to Anthony Bowie, who made that quick spin and got two. And a foul up front. Harry Young will be charged with a personal.
Mannion with a big first half. He's got 18 points so far.
He's one of those players who seems between CBA great and NBA average.
You can see him there. There he gets the step, the reach in, and Perry Young just isn't really quick enough to stay with him. Reached in, tried to stop him, and that sends Mannion to the line. He brought up a good point. He was with the Pistons for a couple of 10-day contracts, and NBA rules say you can sign a guy to two 10-day contracts. At that point, you either have to sign him for the rest of the year or he's got to be released, and they said, okay, we'll see you around pace.
And again, it could be a matter of where you go, too. I mean, he's playing with the Pistons. They don't have a lot of weak spots. They're having another good year up in Detroit. So, like anything else in life, sometimes it's not
how good you are, but where you are. Jones the other way, all the way, and he's fouled.
Well, Bannister hit the deck, as you can see. Not only is he huge, but he's a good actor, too, because there's no way he should fall back.
Well, real good, so.
And that's 277% for the year, so you can almost bet that he'll hit at least two of three.
There's the odds are right now,
hey,
down to that.
I saw you change your mind there when you saw that one roll off. Hey, you want to go for one out of three, Jim?
You can almost bet he'd make at least one out of three.
I think the odds are with you.
Well, the Quad City Thunder get away with one there. Quarter lead, 23-15. Bowie outside, yeah.
And that's what the Thunder need. They need Anthony to light it up here. He's got to get hot. He's got to start putting some points in.
Yeah, not a lot is going right here for the Quad City Thunder in the second quarter, but yet they only trail the game by two, in the quarter by six, and the ball is tipped, and out of bounds, they say it's off net. Now both officials disagree with each other. Greg Jones trying to help out. The official on your right said it was Thunderball, that it went off of Kenny Knapp. The official on your left said, no, it went off of Terry Young's knee. And now we'll have the conference, the summit, and will it be Baryshnikov or Bush? Let's see.
Well, I'll tell you what, I think it did go off his knee, and that's the way the officials call it. The official here was right in front of us, and it did go off his knee after Perry Young was able to tip it. The official down here, the trail official, saw it, made the correct call, and convinced the other official that maybe his eyesight was a little better on that play, and the Thunder will have the ball.
Oh, Carmichael with his hands all over Jones.
Well, would you like to go up against Brent Carmichael? The guy is quick. He's always got his hands moving, and he sure makes it tough on a point guard to get a play started.
Thunder going for the game tie on this trip down. 8 seconds remaining. Shot clock. Bowie, tough shot. Too tough, as it turns out. A whistle and a foul. They're going to call the Thunder with a personal. And is it Herb Blunt or Ken Green? Let's hope it's Blunt.
And I think you're right. It's Herb Blunt. He's going to pick up his second foul. So the Thunder start to pick up fouls right and left. But, you know, Dan Panaccio is quite a player in college. He may be shooting up here before this one's over.
Well, it's not a first for Dan Panaccio to take over the head coaching reins. He did that three times at Rochester when he worked with that organization. And according to orders, as they trail the quarter 25-17, trail the game by four as Bowie works up quickly against Knapp. Terry Young, one-on-one against Mannion. Nice move, but helping out was Bannister. Bannister came over and slapped it away. Mannion up to Carmichael. He waits, and it gets it taken away by Jones. And now we've got a ball headed out of bounds, and a nice save by Bannister. Right back to Blunt. Welcome to soccer, folks. It looks like either that or Australian rules rugby or football. Oh, look at this.
I'll give Bannister the credit there. He went up to the shot, Blunt rammed it right back in his face, but then he had the presence of mind to just tap the ball down to Carmichael for the easy two.
Jones with a silencer in the three.
That's exactly what the Thunder need. They've got to have some three-point shooting out of Jones to keep them in this one.
A minute 52 now remaining here in the second quarter. Thunder took the first quarter. 32-28, and the missed shot by Nat has been really called. That's a bad pass. Blunt threw it up court. He didn't see that Nat had a read on that the whole way, and it's kicked away by Nat. Somebody got their hand in there. Jones, 3-on-2 from 23. He missed everything.
Now, that's called an air ball, and no matter what league you play in, and that's not what the Thunder need, they don't need some useless turnovers. That not a turnover, just a bad shot. But before, when Blunt's trying to make a length of the court pass, that's not what you need when you're an ailing team and you need to make every chance count.
Well, sometimes the tempo gets in your head, and I think that's what happened to Greg that last time, because the last couple of minutes have been fairly hectic, and he was going for the three-point shot in the tie. Jones and Mannion playing a little bump and run with each other. Mannion kicks it out to Nat, who hasn't hit a three-pointer all night. That string continues. Ken Green with a rebound. Cross-court pass, Bowie. Bowie with a head of steam gets it slapped away by Mannion. That was good defense. Bowie didn't think so. The other way is Lewis. Finger roll, didn't get anything. Quad City Thunder's basketball. This is not the kind of basketball in the last 5 minutes that either Coach Mauro Panaccio or his son Dan or Coach Charlie Rosen would agree with putting on film and showing someone, but that's the way it's been.
No, they won't do a clinic with this film, but certainly it has to be to the advantage of the Thunder, who played rather sloppy in the last few minutes, but haven't been buried in this game or still find themselves much in it, only down 3 points.
Green's got to give it up. He does so to Bowie. Bowie was fouled, no call. Blocked back up at it. Hello.
And it looked like he got fouled, but the official didn't see it that way.
30 seconds remaining here. The quarter's a lost cause, but the Thunder only trail, as you see, by one. Quarter 27-22. Nat will keep trying, and he'll keep missing. Lewis with a rebound, and the Thunder was lucky that that did not go in.
Well, that was a bad break, and I don't know how many times we've seen it here in the first half, where the ball comes off, loose ball, and it comes right to a Rockford player, and I think maybe that's a case of standing around a bit too much because you just don't feel like you haven't got the legs. A young white ball but pointed in the way of the Thunder, and apparently his mouth didn't work right, but his arm did, and Thunder will take the ball down the court.
8 seconds remaining, first half. Thunder can tie or go ahead with a three. Once outside, I'd say better get it in quickly. Jones, and it won't go down. Woo! It came awful close, and we've got a tight one here at the Rockford Metro Center. Quad City Thunder leads the season series 5-2. They trail in this one after both teams split quarters. Thunder taking the first quarter. The Lightning the second is 56-54. Home team at the moment. We're coming back with our halftime show right after you see Mr. Blunt do what he likes to do.
We'll toss it up. The tip controlled by Topeka, and here we go. Lightning wants to push the ball. Maybe put a little pressure on the guards, too. Carmichael will guard Cedric Hunter. Good matchup there. Right wing, Farrell takes it up the middle. Passes the ball off, taken by Carmichael. Farrell really forced that and got in trouble. Left side, Milt Newton going baseline, back out to Carmichael. Superby fires a tray. No. Rebound tipped. It comes out back to Carmichael. Lightning getting a new shot clock, and they'll reset the offense. Down low, Woodside posted up against Jackson. On the dribble, backing in the lane, faking the hook shot, yes. Steve Woodside scores the first 2 points of this ballgame. Rockford with a record of 12-10 at home. This is the only time we'll play Topeka at home during the regular season. Shot from outside is no good. Rebound tip. Terrell fired from outside and missed. Rebound off to Cofield. Co pushing. Right side, Newton the shot up, no. Rebound on the floor, out to Cofield. Co, top of the key. Left wing, Carmichael, outside shot, bingo. Rockford scores the first 4 points of this ballgame. Lightning trying to win its fourth in a row at home. Left side, Hunter. Low left, into Rinsky, make up the second in a row at home. They go back inside, Hunter dishes off inside. The shot by Farrell is up and good. Counts the basket, and he was fouled.
4-2, just underway at the Metro Center. Matter of fact, Farrell has his right thigh wrapped. He did not play the second half last Tuesday at Albany, and Coach Mike Riley says he'll see how he can go today. 10 to shoot, high right. Phillips penetrating in the lane, fakes the shot, no, a whistle and a foul. Didn't look like much of one, but we'll take it. Now we'll go on Jim Rowinski, 67% foul shooter. He's played 6 games for the Lightning. Missed 5 games when he went back to the West Coast to shoot a commercial. Couple commercials as he misses the second foul shot too. Orlando Phillips misses them both. Topeka rebounds. Lightning leads it 4-2. Left baseline to Jackson. Back out to Cedric Hunter, top of the key. Low right in the paint to Jackson. Back outside to Hunter. The shot up and in. Cedric Hunter ties the ball game at 4. 10:04 left to play in the first quarter. Carmichael on the dribble, directing traffic. High left to Steve Woodside. High right, Orlando Phillips. Orlando looking inside, left wing Freddie Cofield. Looking inside for Woodside. They want to play a two-man game. Outside shot by Coe is good. Freddie Cofield knocks it down from 20. Rockford up by a deuce, 6-4. Hunter, high left, Jim Rowinski, facing the basket against Phillips. Fires it up, no. Rebound, tipped out by Jackson, but taken by Carmichael. Carmichael dribbling out, almost lost it. Gets the ball off to Freddie Cofield. Coe, right side, goes low right into Phillips, shot is up and good. Orlando Phillips gives Rockford an 8-4 lead. Set 9:22 left to play in the first quarter. Right wing, Dwayne Farrell. Low right, Craig Jackson posted up against Woodside. High left, Perry Moss fires up a three, can't hit it. Rebound, low right, Milt Newton gets it out to Carmichael. Here come the Lightning. Carmichael down the right side. Feeds it underneath. The pass tipped out of bounds by Topeka. Rockford will inbound it from the left corner. 16
double
to shoot.
Double B.
Left wing, Steve Woodside. Looking in. Pass, so we got a whistle and a foul away from the ball that will go on Milt Newton.
Lightning foul number 35, Milt Newton.
Second foul on Milt.
Go.
Lenny Watson says he pushed off when he went to get that pass. Cedric Hunter between the circles for Topeka. Comes left side. Still on the dribble against Carmichael. Reverses right wing now. Harry Moss. Low right. They try to post up Craig Jackson against Cofield, who had him on the switch. The pass was too tall, though, and out of bounds. So you get a feeling from the first few minutes of the ball game that if Rockford just plays a decent ball game here this afternoon, they will win. High left, Woodside in the paint for Cofield. Pass tipped away, taken by Farrell. Here comes Topeka. Farrell driving the shot up and good. Wayne Farrell with 4 points. Rockford leads at 8-6. Right when I say that, Rockford turns the ball over, and Topeka gets an easy bucket. Left wing. Newton has the ball knocked out of bounds by Farrell. Rockford will inbound from the side with 18 to shoot. Cofield, high right. Picks up the dribble. Backdoor lob. Goes into Carmichael. We got a whistle and a foul. Carmichael made a nice cut inside. What's the call? 3 second call against the Lightning. Thought we had a foul and said 3 seconds. It's the call from Lenny Watson. Topeka with the ball. Rockford leads it by two. A sellout crowd this afternoon at the Metro Center. Left wing, Perry Moss on the dribble. Spots up the shot, no. Rebound tip, controlled by Cofield. Here come the Lightning. Freddie pushing the ball down the middle. Driving all the way. The shot up and in. Freddie goes coast to coast. He's got four. Rockford leads at 10-6. Hunter between the circles for the Sizzlers. Left baseline, the outside shot by Moss, rims out, rebound, low right. Newton gets the ball out to Carmichael, back to Milt, penetrating up the middle, the shot is up and good. Rockford running the break, first 2 points this afternoon for Milt Newton, and Rockford leads it 12-6 with 7:20 left to play in quarter number one. Rockford wants to push it this afternoon. Hunter penetrating left side. Spin move. The shot is up off the glass. No. Ball tipped in the lane. Controlled by Jackson. The fadeaway. No. Rebound. Carmichael. Here come the Lightning. 4-on-4. Cofield. Right side. Carmichael. Shot. No. Rebound taken by Jackson. Gets the ball to Hunter. Here comes Topeka. Behind him. He goes to Moss. Penetrates. The ball slapped away. And now a traveling call on Perry Moss. Timeout will be taken by the Lightning. 6:53 left to play in the first quarter. It's the Rockford Lightning 12, the Topeka.
Every morning, have coffee with us on WROK.
6:53 left to play in the first quarter. Rockford leading Topeka 12-6. Lightning with the basketball. Rockford shooting 6 of 9. Topeka shooting 3 of 10. Top of the key, Phillips fires. Can't hit it. Rebound tipped to Woodside, goes back up. The ball stripped away, taken by Perry Moss. Here come the Sizzlers. Hunter penetrating through the lane, dishes off to Owinski. The fadeaway around, no. Rebound, Steve Woodside. Outlet hits Milt Newton in the back, taken by Owinski. Off the Hunter, shot up and in. That's just sloppy basketball. Cedric Hunter with 4 points. Rockford leads at 12-8. Rockford leading the battle of the boards now. 11-3. Turnovers. Three apiece. High right, Cofield. Top of the key, Newton fires it up. Rims out, rebound, tipped, a whistle and a foul. It's going to go on Steve Woodside, going over the back of Craig Jackson. First down, Steve Woodside. Second team foul this quarter against the Lightning. 6:05 left to play in the first quarter. Rockford leading at 12-8. Moss picks up the dribble. Top of the key, Rowinski. They give him room. Right wing now, Cedric Hunter. Low right, Craig Jackson, 10 to shoot. Jackson wheeling on the paint, the shot no. Rebound, Orlando Phillips, and here come the Lightning. Freddie Cofield coming down the right side. Pass, left side, Milt Newton, the shot in the lane. No, a whistle and a foul on Craig Jackson. It's his first, team second. So the foul line will be Milt Newton for two. He's got 4 points, and Rockford leads at 14-8 with 5:39 left to play in quarter number one. High left, Perry Moss. Left wing, Dwayne Farrell, top of the key, Cedric Hunter, around a Rowinski screen. Back to Rowinski, top of the key, wants to penetrate. Fakes, got away with the travel, the shot, no. Rebound on the floor, picked off by the Lightning. Phillips dribbling out, off to Carmichael. Brent feeds it inside, pass tap to Cofield, pass inside tap. Now it comes out, finally controlled by Jim Rowinski. Lightning's got to get crisper in executing those passes. Moss penetrating in the lane, shot, no, a whistle and a foul.
Lightning foul number 44, Steve Woodside.
Foul will be on Steve Woodside.
Third team foul.
His second. Team's third. Moss hits two out of two. And the Lightning lead at 14-10 with 5:06 left to play in the first quarter. At halftime, we'll be talking with Grand Rapids coach Jim Sleeper. Orlando Phillips, high right. High left to Steve Woodside. High right, Milt Newton tend to shoot. In the paint, they go to Phillips. The shot is up and good. Orlando Phillips using that left hand. He's got 4 points. Rockford leads at 16-10. 4:44 left to play in quarter number one. Hunter on the dribble high right against Carmichael. Low right, Perry Moss posted up against Cofield. Through the lane, the shot is up and good. Phillips grabbed the rim. They could have called goaltending on that, too. Moss with 4 points. Rockford leads at 16-12. High right, Orlando Phillips. Right wing, Freddie Cofield. Looking inside. Still looking. Moss gives him a lot of room. Low right into Woodside. Tend to shoot. Woodside on the dribble. Going in. The shot is up. No. Rebound tipped. A whistle and a foul. It should go on. Craig Jackson going over the back of Woodside. Yes, it does. Second foul on Jackson. 13th foul this quarter against Topeka. Rockford will inbound from the side here with the new 24. Carmichael, top of the key. High left. Orlando Phillips. Looking, pass inside, not a good pass, stolen by Hunter. The pass was not there. Hunter pushes the ball. Left side, Jackson driving, the shot rejected. Taken by Farrell, he goes up and scores. Dwayne Farrell with 6 points. Rockford's lead cut down to a deuce now. 16-14 with 3:54 left in the quarter. Carmichael, high left to Woodside. Woodside looks in for the cutters, top of the key, Cofield. High left, Carmichael. Carmichael penetrating at the foul line, forces the shot, no, but a whistle and a foul. Going to go on Craig Jackson. It's his third, team's fourth. Coming forward out of Wyoming. Brent Carmichael at the foul line for two. Super B with 2 points this afternoon. 5'9 guard out of Northern Iowa, averaging 8.2 a ball game. And the first foul shot rims around and goes through. Brent will get one more. Shooting 71% from the foul line. That percentage has been going up. Second shot is also good. Brent with 4 points. Rockford leads at 18-14. 3:40 left to play in the first quarter. Best crowd of the season here this afternoon with the famous chicken on hand. Hunter on the dribble, high right against Carmichael. Almost lost it, penetrates in, back outside to Moss, 18-footer, yes. Perry Moss with 6 points. 18-16, Rockford leads it, 3:18 left to play in quarter number one. Lightning has to do the job defensively. That was the main problem last night at Quad City. Phillips, left wing. Milt Newton driving the baseline. Dishes off to Woodside in the paint. Right wing. Brent Carmichael fires from outside. No. Rebound comes out high. Taken by Woodside. Feeds it right wing. Milt Newton pulls up. The shot off the glass. No. Rebound up and in by Orlando Phillips. Orlando on the putback. He's got 6 points and Rockford leads it 20-16. 2:46 left to play here in the first quarter. Hunter slowly on the dribble, comes right side against Brent Carmichael. Looking in. Top of the key, Moss a whistle. Now an illegal defense called against the Lightning. Milt Newton out of position. As a timeout will be taken by Topeka. 2:35 left to play in the first quarter. It's the Rockford Lightning 20, the Topeka. Perry Moss and Charlie Rose, the still have some conversation. Perry commenting on Charlie's clothes. High left, Cedric Hunter, picked up by Carmichael. Looking inside, they want to post up Rowinski against Phillips. Can't do it. He penetrates baseline. The pass off the hands of Tony Martin, controlled in the right corner by Moss. Moss gets a double team. High right now, Dwayne Farrell, 9 to shoot. Low right, into Tony Martin. A whistle and a traveling call on Tony Martin. Fourth turnover of the quarter committed by the Sizzlers. Rockford with the ball in a 4-point lead. Left wing, Milt Newton. High left. left, Steve Woodside. Woodside back on the wing to Milt Newton. Looking inside, then to shoot. Out to Woodside, high right, penetrates up the lane, dishes off Carmichael, shot up and in. Give the bucket to Brent Carmichael, the assist to Steve Woodside. 22-16, Rockford leads it, minute 50 left in the quarter. Hunter between the circles against Carmichael. Hands the ball off to Moss, penetrates right side of the lane, dishes off right baseline beyond Tony Martin and out of bounds. Martin just joined this team. He's only played one game for him. So they've got the same problem the Lightning does. A lot of new faces, players not familiar with each other. High left, Milt Newton holding, low left, inside to Phillips, shot up and in. Phillips moving well away from the ball, good pass by Milt Newton. 8 points for Orlando Phillips. Rockford leads it 24-16. A minute 20 left to play in the first quarter. This is Rockford's biggest lead of the game. A whistle, we got a foul away from the ball. Now Phillips and Rowinski shove each other. They were banging down low. The official separator, Jim Rowinski and Orlando Phillips. And then we got a double technical here. It was a personal foul on Orlando Phillips, his first, the team's fourth, and a double technical. They will not shoot the double technicals, but it will cost each player. And if they each one, were to get another one, or if either one, they'd be ejected. Topeka inbounds from the side with a new shot clock. Lob, low left, posted up Rowinski against Phillips. Turnaround shot is up and good. Rowinski's first 2 points of the ball game. Rockford leads at 24-18 with a minute four left to play in the first quarter. Carmichael, high right to Phillips. Orlando looking inside. Woodside, top of the key. Checked by Martin, right wing, Milt Newton. Lob, low right, into Phillips, faking the shot up, no. Rebound, tip up and in. Give it to Brent Carmichael. How did Super B get inside like that at 5'9"? 8 points for Brent Carmichael, 26-18. Rockford leads it, 40 seconds left in the first quarter. Hunter, high right to Kellogg. We got a whistle and a foul away from the ball. It'll be on Tony Martin. His first. 38 seconds left in the first quarter. Rockford with the ball and an 8-point lead. Carmichael between the circles. Looking inside. High right, Freddie Cofield. Co-holding against Kellogg, who's just checked in the game. Penetrating right side. The shot rejected. A whistle and a foul. Farrell came over to reject the ball, but the foul went on Ron Kellogg. 28-18, Rockford leads at 22 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Hunter between the circles. Right wing, Farrell fires it up, yes. Dwayne Farrell hits from outside, he's got 8 points. Rockford leads at 28-20 with 10 seconds left in the quarter. Rockford playing for one here. Carmichael, top of the key. Comes left side on the dribble, penetrating. The outside shot by Cofield. Yes! A 3-point bucket at the buzzer. Count it. Rockford wins the first quarter. The score, the Rockford Lightning 31, the Topeka Sizzlers 20. I'll be back with more right after this on your Rockford Lightning Radio Network. We blocked, but it's still going to be Topeka basketball. I don't know if Cofield got hit before he shot it or what. 97-86. Rockford leads at 8:49 left to play. Cedric Hunter between the circles against Cofield. Right wing, Ron Kellogg going baseline. The shot, yes.
Ron Kellogg
with 11 points. Rockford leads at 97-88. 8.5 minutes left to play. Rockford just have one good run going here. The outcome would be over. Would be no longer in doubt. Rockford would have the ball game. Right wing, Milt Newton. Bow right in the paint. Orlando Phillips. Shot is up off the glass. No. Rebound tip. No. Taken on the floor by Dwayne Farrell. And here come the Sizzlers. Cedric Hunter. Going through the lane. Stops. The shot, yes. Cedric Hunter with 17 points. Rockford leads at 97-90. 7:58 left to play. Cofield between the circles. Picked up by Hunter. High left to Woodside. High right, Orlando Phillips. Phillips looking in the lane. Off to Woodside, top of the key. 5 seconds to shoot. Woodside almost lost it. Off to Cofield now. Three to shoot. Got to do something with it. The shot is good. After he beats the buzzer, the shot just rimmed out. Rebound off to Topeka. They get the ball out to Kellogg. Kellogg down the right side. Out to Farrell. High left, Cedric Hunter. Low left, Rowinski. The pass stolen by Phillips. That was a lazy pass. Ball tapped on the floor to Newton. The jam. Oh, baby. Milton Newton with 8 points. Rockford leads at 99-90 with 7:10 left to play. Hunter. High left, Wayne Farrell. Picked up by Newton. Low left, Rowinski, facing up against Orlando Phillips. 10 to shoot, driving inside. Rowinski, the shot is up. No. Rebound, Phillips, out with Cofield. Here come the Lightning. Cofield, right side. Milt Newton going in. The shot off the glass. No, a whistle and a foul. An offensive foul on Milt Newton. You got to be kidding me. His fifth foul. Timeout taken by the Lightning. 6:49 left to play. It's the Rockford Lightning, 99. Carmichael with 27 points, 7 assists and 9 rebounds and 7 steals. He's not that far away from a quadruple-double. Cedric Hunter with the basketball for the Sizzlers. Picks up the dribble, top of the key. Picked it up way too high. High right now, Dwayne Farrell against Newton. Farrell on the dribble, 10 to shoot. Goes baseline. Back outside, Ron Kellogg fires up a three. Can't hit it. Rebound. Right baseline, Milt Newton out to Carmichael. Carmichael, left wing, Milt Newton. Newton looking inside. Trying to find Phillips at the foul line. Woodside instead, 15-footer, no rebound. Phillips going back up, the shot rejected. On the floor now, it's saved inbounds by Topeka. No, it's not. Kellogg saved it in, but the pass was too tall for Cedric Hunter. It goes out of bounds. Rockford will inbound at midcourt with a new shot clock. Lightning leading the game by 9, trailing the quarter by 5. Carmichael on the dribble. High left, Steve Woodside. Left wing, Milt Newton. Newton looking inside. Pass, low left, into Phillips. Gets the double team back to Newton. The outside shot. No, rebound. Low right, taken by Cedric Hunter. Hunter dribbling the ball out himself. Pass down the floor. Right side, Farrell driving in. Loses the ball, a whistle and a foul. It'll go on Freddie Cofield. His first. Team's third of the quarter. Rockford leads the game by 8, trails the quarter by 6. A crowd of 8,452, second largest ever in Lightning history here at the Metro Center. Second shot is also good by Farrell. 99-92, Rockford leads it. Carmichael walks the ball down the right side, directing traffic here. Off the Cofield, penetrating, 10-footer, yes. Ready, go with 36 points. 101-92, Rockford leads it. 5:24 left to play. Hunter, top of the key for the Sizzlers. Pass stolen by Newton. Here come the Lightning, 2-on-1. Newton pushing the ball all the way and jamming. Oh, baby! Milt Newton coast to coast. He's got 10 points. 103-92. Rowinski through the lane. A traveling call on Jim Rowinski. Rockford leading the game by 11 now. Driven the quarter by just 3. 5:08 left to play. Carmichael slowly down the right side against Cedric Hunter. Looking inside, right wing, Freddie Cofield penetrates up the lane. Left-handed shot around now. The tip up and in by Milt Newton. 12 points for Milt. Rockford leads at 105-92, 4:45 left to play. Rockford trails the quarter by 1, a timeout taken by Topeka. 4:44 left to play. It's the Rockford Lightning, 105. Cedric Hunter, between the circles, comes right side against Brent Carmichael. They're looking in for Farrell. They're trying to post up Farrell against Milt Newton. Newton fronting Farrell. Lob pass into Dwayne. Inside, fakes the shot up and in. They got the backdoor lob into him and didn't get enough help from the weak side. 105-94, Rockford leads it. 4:22 left to play. Carmichael slowly down the left side against Cedric Hunter. Looking in. Still looking. Off the Cofield, top of the key. Cole penetrating. Dishes off for Woodside. The pass beyond him and out of bounds. Cole was cutting through the lane. The pass looked like it was there at first, but then Woodside cut into the basket. Ball went beyond him and out of bounds. 105-94, Rockford leads at 4:03 left to play. Low right, Rowinski gets a double team, looks for the cutters, back outside to Hunter. High left, Kellogg, fires up a three, yes. 14 points for Ron Kellogg. 105-97, Rockford leads. 3:49 up to play. This thing isn't over yet. Rockford leading the game by 8, trailing the quarter by 6. Carmichael down the left side, picked up by Hunter. Left wing, Freddie Cofield against Kellogg on the dribble, going up the lane, dishes off to Phillips. The shot is up. Noah whistling a foul. Foul's going to go on Rowinski. That's his second. 107-97. Rockford leads it. 3:31 left to play. Our Hardy's hold'em number tonight is 99, so the Lightning has to hold Topeka to just 2 point more points here to get everybody in the house a quarter-pound burger. Illegal defense called against the Lightning now. Steve Woodside, they say, was in the wrong place. That's the second time it's been called against the Lightning, so it is a technical foul. Kellogg is ninth in the league in foul shooting percentage at 86%. So 107-98, Rockford leads it. And Topeka inbounds from the side with a new shot clock. Top of the key, Hunter. The shot is up and good. 19 points for Cedric Hunter. 107-100, Rockford leads. 3:05 left to play. This game is not over. High right, Carmichael, right wing, Cofield, low right, Orlando Phillips against Rowinski in the lane, faking, shooting, and scoring. Orlando Phillips with 24. 109-100, Rockford leads it. 2:50 left to play. Hunter on the dribble against Brent Carmichael, wants to penetrate. Behind him to Kellogg. Kellogg, he goes right side, fakes, dishes inside. The shot is rejected and taken by Phillips. Outlet Carmichael. Rockford coming down 3-on-2. Woodside off to Milt Newton. The shot, no. Slapped up in the lane. Finally taken by Farrell. Outlet pass to Hunter. He penetrates. Dishes off to Rowinski. The shot rejected by Phillips. Coming out with it is Martin. He is craned as he went up with the shot. Foul's going to go on Steve Woodside. His fifth, all inbounds. Milt with 12 points here tonight, this afternoon. First shot is up and good. He will get one more. Milt now 3-for-3 from the foul line. 1:40 left to play. Next shot is up and also good. So Milt hits 2 out of 2. Rockford will now inbound. Left wing, Brent Carmichael. Carmichael against Hunter. Low left. In the Phillips, backing in, back out to Carmichael. Carmichael spots up the shot, rims out, rebound. Slapped around the lane, taken by Rowinski. As the ball slapped away, stolen finally by Carmichael. Shot is up and good. Carmichael with 29 points. Rockford leads at 113-102. 3-point shot, air ball by Kellogg, but the putback is good by Dwayne Farrell. Got to come up with the ball. 113-104, Rockford leads it. 7 minutes left to play. Rockford trailing the quarter by 5. Double team, Cofield out to Carmichael, high left. Inside, Milt Newton to cutting Phillips. He jams it. 26 points for Orlando Phillips. 115-104, Rockford leads it. 58 seconds left to play. Rockford trails the quarter by 3. Lightning now has the game won. They are playing for the quarter. Hunter penetrates left side. An offensive foul on Cedric Hunter. He knocked down Brent Carmichael. Third foul on Hunter. 21! Carmichael with 9 steals here this afternoon. That ties his own league high. He's also got 27 points and 9 assists. 21! High left. Woodside, right wing, Cofield. The shot, no. Rebound, low left, Farrell. Gets the ball out to Hunter. Hunter dribbling down, feeds it left side. He overled Ron Kellogg out of bounds. It goes back to the Lightning. 28 seconds left to play here. Rockford has the game won. They lead at 115-104, but Rockford trails the quarter by 3. They need a bucket here. They want to win this quarter. Carmichael between the circles. Off the Woodside, high left to Freddie Cofield. Spots up the 3-point shot. No. Rebound taken by Farrell. 10 seconds left. Farrell penetrating, driving, and jamming. 115-106, Rockford leads. It's 7 seconds left to play. 3-point shot by Super B. No. Rebound, Brent, up and good. 1 second left to play. Inbound pass. As the fourth quarter and the game comes to an end. Topeka wins the fourth quarter, 29-26. Rockford wins the game. The final score, the Rockford Lightning, 117. The Topeka Sizzlers, 106.
Some said it couldn't be done. Take an expansion CPA franchise.